We will see that what is the variation and its properties. Okay, no need to write anything. Already I have sent all the materials. No need to send, just listen, that is enough. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the variation and its properties. Actually, the same topic I am discussing third day, because it's very, very important concept. Once you clear in that concept, then you will be getting that good idea in this method of variation of parameter. So here, first point is method of solving variational problems. That is, what is the variational problems? Variational problems is finding that maxima and minima of the functional. Okay, so method of solving the variational problem or problems involving the investigation of functionals for maxima and minima are extremely similar to the method of investigating functions for maxima and minima. It is therefore worthwhile recalling briefly the theory of maxima and minima of the functions. In parallel, introduce analogous concepts and prove similar theorems for functionals. Okay, that is, we are going to discuss function and functionals. Okay, how the function is defined for maximum minima, how the function is defined for maximum minima, how to find that maximum minima for function, already given. Anyway, I will send the notes for to finding the maxima and minima for that ordinary differential and partial differential both. Today I will send it. Please, you go through that, you get that clear cut idea to find that maximum and minima for the functions. Okay, so here we are going to see that how to find that the extreme value of the functional. Now this left hand side is that for properties of the function, right hand side is that properties of functional. Okay, the first point is a variable z is a function of a variable quantity x. Actually, how can you write that one function pi equal to f of x? Yeah, so y equal to f of x is the function. At the same time, so okay, here it is given, z equal to f of x is the function. At the same time, what is called the functional? Function of function, already I mentioned that function of function is called the functional. So v is the one function, and then v contains one more function y of x. So function of function is called the functional. So here we can see that this point, a variable z is a function of a variable quantity x. Variable quantity x, actually here x is called the which variable? Z and x is what? The variable. Simple question, na?
Independent.
Independent. X is called the independent variable. Similarly, here, in case if you are writing that v equal to v of x, so v of y of x, then y of x is called the independent function. Independent function. So the variable quantity v is a functional dependent on a function y of x. So here, depend on x, one variable x, but here it is depend on a function y of x. Both are different. If to each function y of x of a certain class of the function y of x, there corresponds a value v, that is, we have the correspondence to the function y of x that corresponds to the number v. Okay, very simple. What is called the function? Function relates two sets. Function relates two sets. So what is called z here? Z is called that for every value of x, some value, corresponding value z is there, some value is there. But here v is one function. At the same time, See, already you sent the notes. Okay, you take the printout and then you have to write this note also. I am writing some other diagrams na. At the same time, just you draw the diagrams for your reference. Okay, so here what is that domain here? Domain is y of x. Domain is y of x. And then codomain is v. Codomain is v. So there is a correspondent value y of x for every value of y of x, some value is there in v. That is here explained. So here finally what functions of several variables are defined in the similar fashion. Okay. So what is the important point here? This is the important point. The correspondent value, if every value of x over a certain range of x, there corresponds a value of z. Okay, this is one point. Similarly here, if to each function y of x of a certain class of a function y of x, their correspond value v is there. Okay, for this point, this is the diagram. For this point, this is the diagram. Okay, that is the first point, first property. Second property is that the increment delta x of the argument x of a function f of x for the difference between two values of the variable delta x equal to x minus x1. What is called the delta x? Here, in case one axis is there, we can draw this diagram. Axis is there. So here, x naught or some x is there. Somewhere it is x naught or x1 is there, x1, somewhere x is there, somewhere x, I don't want to define because it is a variable. X may be very small or large, whatever it may be. But what is delta x? Delta x is that x minus x1, the difference between these two, that means the distance between these two points is delta x. Delta x, this is delta x. Okay, fine. Now similarly we can find what is functional for the functional delta y, the difference delta y, that is y of x minus y1 of x. In the similar way we can draw here, we are writing that delta x in the axis, we are writing the delta x in the axis, whereas the delta y in the space. How to write the delta y here? If one function is there, in this function, this is the point y1. This is the point y1. Okay. A increment is some y of x. A increment is y of x. See, you see the difference between what is that function and functional. What is a function and functional? When you are writing that the increment of the variable or the increment delta x, you have to write in the axis. You have to write in the axis x1 minus x, okay, or x minus x1. Similarly here, what is delta y? That is you have to write in the space. Write in the space. That means it is delta y. Delta y of x, because it is not only that y1 of x, that is y1 of x, it is y of x. So delta y equal to y of x minus y1 of x. So for this point, this is the diagram. For this point, this is the diagram. So we can read that the statement once again for the difference between function and functional. The increment delta x of the argument x of the function f of x is the difference between two values of the variable. So whereas here you have to write that not variable, here two functions. So the definition, how can you write the definition? Very easily you can remember that the definition for function and functional. In case if you are know the definition for function, easily you can remember that. You can write the definition for the functional. Wherever the variable is there, you have to write the function. Okay. So second point we can write for functional. You can read for functional the increment or the variation. So here you can see that the word. So here only the word is started, variation. So variation, increment or variation, delta y of the argument, y of x of your functional, v of y of x is the difference between the two functions, y of x minus y1 of x. Here it is assumed that y of x varies in arbitrary fashion in some class of functions. Okay, this is a second point. Third point is that a function f of x is called continuous. A function f of x is called continuous. Anybody can you tell me what is called continuous definition? In ordinary case, ordinarily, how you define the continuous? How can you define the continuous? Anybody? Any general formula you can write. You can tell me that. No one. When the function is said to be continuous, when the function is said to be discontinuous. Even in the last semester itself, we have discussed. Even in the BSc also, you have studied that.
Sir, continuous has smooth curve.
Continuous.
Continuous is smooth, sir.
Okay, fine. Actually, continuous and discontinuous. What is the difference between continuous and discontinuous? When the function is said to be continuous. Okay, are you able to tell that y of x naught that is equal to limit? I'm not able to write very fluently because I'm not having that digital board now, so that's why. Just you can understand. Okay. X equal to x tends to x naught y of x. What is the definition? Anybody? Why others are not trying that? Simply sitting there. Something try, it may be wrong or correct. It is not the problem at all. If you're trying, then only you can know that, because the calculus of variation is not the simple subject. It's a very, very tough one. Because you have to be, and then keep it in your mind. It is your subject. It is not my subject. Be interactive, then only you can know that. What is this? What is the definition of this? Is it limit of your function? Limit and continuous. So then when that function is said to be continuous?
When the limit are equal.
When the values of the limit are
equal.
Equal means, in case if it is f of x is there, I'm writing two functions, f of x, f1 of x, f2 of x. Okay, two functions I'm writing. When the two functions are said to be continuous, when the two functions are said to be discontinuous. The first semester also you have studied this. not only in my subject, in some other subject mode, so let me start this. When the function is said to be that continuous, when the function is said to be discontinuous, these two functions. Suppose some x naught is there, x naught minus h. X naught minus h. In case if it is x naught plus h is there, where h tends to zero, f1 of x f1 of x naught equal to f2 of x naught. Both are should be equal. Okay, listen. In the plus one book, it is very clearly given that what is limit and continuous for the differentiation. It is the first chapter in the volume two, plus one book. Many times I told that please go to the tnbooks.com. Please download all the mathematics book. You have to go through all the mathematics basic books. It's so important. Okay. Even if you are studying that whatever it may be, it is MSc or PhD, whatever it may be, then the basic is there in that plus two level, plus one level, 10th level also. Okay. Very thorough in that 10 plus 1 plus 2, then you can handle any class. Okay, fine, anyway. The function f of x is called the continuous if to a small change of x, there corresponding a small change in function f of x. Okay, a function v of y of x is called the continuous if it is change of y of x. Actually, here I am telling that continuous is a different definition. Okay, a functional v of y of x is called the continuous if to a small change of y of x there's correspondent a small changes in the functional v of y of x. That meaning is from the first point I will come. That means in case you are relating two functions, two values, na you are relating that x and z here, if anything is changed in x, correspondingly there is some changes in z. Similarly, in some changes in y, correspondingly that range, the range also will be having some different value. That means if two functions are there, that mean okay, fine. I'm draw through graph. So what is this says? In some changes in y of x, what is in case if it is a function, in case the minimum distance is this one. Okay, in case some changes in y of x, there is also some changes in v of y of x. That is the meaning. Yes, y and y1 point. The latter definition requires some explanation for that question immediately arises as that we change the function y of x, which is the argument of the functional we called small, or what is the same, what comes y equal to y of x and y equal to y1 of x are considered close or only slightly different. Here two curves are there, y equal to y of x and y equal to y1 of x. For this case only, yesterday we have started that one problem, na zeroth order proximity, first order proximity. For this kind of definition only, we are going to discuss that proximity. Okay, did you go through that proximity? What is mean by proximity? Yesterday I told you. every single point is important. Please tell me, anybody try, what is mean by proximity?
Boundary, sir.
Not boundary. Boundary is not proximity. Boundary is not proximity. Boundary is not proximity. See, yesterday I told, what is mean by very simple. That's why. Yes. What is mean by proximity?
Relations.
Relations is not the proximity. Relations, boundary is not the proximity, relation is not the proximity. Proximity means neighborhood, nearby point, very near point, that is called proximity. If two curves are there, a lot of curves are there, okay, in that here also there are a lot of curves are there. I'm drawing that many number of curves are there, okay. Then when the two curves are said to be proximity, when the two curves are proximity, means if the two curves, the curve 1 and the curve 2 is close to each other, when the two curves are close to each other, that is called the proximity curves. It is called the proximity curves, okay. So next point is very, very important, something you have to note down, that it may be taken that the function y of x and y1 of x are close if the absolute values of the difference y of x minus y1 of x is small. When you set to be it is the y of x minus y1 of x is small, without testing we are not able to tell that. Y of x minus y1 of x is so small, that is the distance is minimum, or the both are in the that mean the, there are the closed curves. How can we say that? For all the values of x for which the function y of x and y1 of x are prescribed, that's why. So without a testing, how can we say that that should be prescribed? That is, we can consider the close as such curves as have close lying ordinates. What is mean by ordinates? The points of the function is called the ordinates. Okay, it is like coordinates, that's all. Close lying ordinates. However, for such definition, proximity of curves, the functionals of kind. Yesterday I have given this definition, v of y of x, x naught to x1, f of x comma y comma y dash dx. Based on this only, I have proved one theorem. That theorem is called that Euler's theorem. Okay. That frequently occur in applications will be continuous only in the exceptional cases due to the presence of the argument y dash in the integrand function. Okay, fine. So within that x comma y, we can't able to say that it is a proximity or not. Why we require that y dash? Yeah. What is mean by y dash first of all? Y dash is increment or a slope or a tangent or a angle. What is called y dash? In case y is the curve, what is called y dash? Is it tangent? Is it normal? Is it slope? Is it change? Okay, for this reason, in many cases, It is more natural to consider as closely only those curves which have close lying ordinates and are close as regards the directions of tangents. Okay. Direction of tangents is there. What is called the direction of tangents? What is called the direction of tangents? Okay, fine. If one coordinate is there, one coordinate, in the coordinate I am drawing one curve. One curve. I am drawing one more curve. One more curve. There are two curves are there. Okay. If I take the two points, the two nearby points, if I draw the tangent here, one tangent, it is one more tangent. It is one more tangent. The angle between two tangent is very small. The angle between two tangents are very small. Then we can say that the two curves, okay, the two points are very near, and then the two points are proximity. And in case if I take two points here, here one point I am taking, here one point I am taking. So what is the tangent for this? It is the tangent, but it is the tangent. Okay. Now see that the angle between two is more than 90 degree. So when you are writing that proximity of the curves, that means in the functions of variation calculus, the variational calculus, that the role of y dash is more important. That reason will be, we will see the reason in the next page. Okay, that just we can see that here the direction of tangents at the respective points, that is to require that for closed curves, not only should be absolute value of the difference y of x minus y dash of x be small, at the same time y dash of x minus y1 dash of x also small. Okay, y of x minus y1 of x, I can understand that. What is mean by the difference of y dash of x minus y dash y1 dash of x? Is it possible to tell anybody? Y of x is one function, y1 of x is one more function. Okay, fine. Not only that functions, the points and the function is not a difference of the points, sorry, difference of functions is not small, but that rate of change of displacement also, the difference between rate of change of displacement also very small. That is the meaning. This is the meaning here. So once again we can read this, some important points. It may be taken that, what are the important points here? Taken that the function y of x and y1 of x are close. Better you can do one thing. Yesterday I have written that one, I have pages now. Please take print out and then read three or more times. Then only you can understand that point one by one. If the absolute value of the difference, what is mean by absolute value? Here one word is there, na? Absolute value. This is also a very simple question. What is mean by absolute value? Anybody? What is mean by absolute value? When you are writing that, when you are take that mod, when you take the mod of any value, that is called the absolute value. Please make note what is called absolute value. So if you are taking anything, if y of x is there, what is absolute value of y of x? Mod of y of x is absolute value. Similarly, the difference is there, but the difference y of x minus y1 of x. So what is absolute value of the difference? If you are taking that mod of y of x minus y1 of x, that is called the absolute value. Any other word is there for the absolute value? One is mod, one more is absolute. Any other word is there for absolute value?
So is it positive?
Maybe. Yeah. It's correct. But positive is okay. What are the argument? Magnitude, is it magnitude? It is positive, okay. But if you are writing the polar coordinates, what is argument and modulus? Modulus and argument are one more word is there, na? We know the argument, the tan inverse of y by x is argument. Then what about the square root of x square plus y square? The name is called square root of x square plus y square is in polar coordinates. In polar coordinates, two things are there. One is that modulus. Is it modulus or magnitude? I don't know exactly that. Anybody, can you tell me that? How can we call that r equal to square root of x square plus y square, na? The technical name is radius, but the proper name is there for this. Okay, anyway, you refer that, please. So next point we can go that. It is sometimes necessary, so hereafter only we will discuss more important points. This is one important note. This is one important note. It is sometimes necessary to consider as close only those functions for which absolute value of each following difference are small. That is y of x minus y1 of x, y dash of x. Here y double dash of x minus y one double dash of x, that is yk of x minus y1 k of x. This compels us to introduce the following definition of proximity. So yesterday I have given this as a question. So please go through the zeroth order proximity and first order proximity. I don't know how many of them are going through this. So zeroth order proximity, what is called that? Zeroth order proximity. The curves y equal to y of x and y equal to y1 of x, there are two closed curves that are there, are close in the sense of zeroth order proximity if the absolute value of the difference y of x and y1 of x is small. In case the coordinates, this is one curve y of x, this is one more curve y1 of x. Okay, some other curves are there. Then here we can say that y of x and y1 of x are so small. So the curves y equal to y of x and y1 of x are close in the sense of zeroth order proximity. the absolute value of the difference y of x minus y1 of x is small. Similarly, for the first order proximity, the curves y equal to y of x and y equal to y1 of x are close in the sense that the first order proximity of the absolute values of the difference y of x minus y1 of x and y dash of x minus y1 dash of x is small. Not only that y of x minus y1 of x is small, y1 dash of x my y dash of x minus y1 dash of x is both are small. Similarly, we can define that kth order proximity. Kth order proximity is that the curves y equal to y of x and y equal to y1 of x are close, that the sense of kth order proximity, if the absolute values of the difference y of x minus y1 of x, y dash of x minus y1 dash of x, yk of x minus y1 k of x are small. Okay. So what are the MCQ? There are three MCQs are there. First MCQ is that the zeroth order proximity, when the functions or difference of the functions is said to be that zeroth order proximity. That is our first one. Second one is first order proximity. The third one is that kth order proximity. Then how can we see that the zeroth order and first order proximity through diagram? Through diagram, you can see here. So this figure 6.1, 6.2 is there. Exhibits the curve close in the sense that zeroth order proximity, but not close the sense of the first order proximity. First order proximity. Since the ordinates are close, but the direction of the tangents are not. So here the ordinates are very close, but the tangents are not very far away. So the difference is more. But in the figure 6.2, are depicted the curve close in the sense that first order proximity. So it's a very simple graphical representation for the zeroth order and first order proximity. Next one is, next point, already we have discussed two points for the function and functional. What are the two points? One is, there is, for every value of x, there is a some corresponding value of z is there for the function. Similarly, for that every value of y of x, some corresponding value of in v is there. Okay, that is the first point. Second point is the increment. Increment is delta x minus x1 is called the increment. Here, the increment delta y is that y of x minus y1 of x. That is the second point. Third point is a function f of x is called the continuous. Okay. So here a function v of y of x is called the continuous if small changes in y of x, there are corresponding small changes in the function v of y of x. That is the third point. It is the point third a. Next point is third a. Third a you can write. Third a. What is the point here? From this definition, it follows that if the curves are close in the sense of the kth order proximity, then they are definitely close in the sense of any lesser order proximity. This is very important. So if you say that it is a kth order proximity, means of course it is first order proximity, second order proximity, third order proximity is there, okay, exist. That is the meaning of this. Now we can refine the concept of continuity of the functional. So what is the concept here? A function f of x is continuous at x equal to x naught. At x equal to x naught, if for any positive epsilon there is delta greater than 0, such that f of x minus f of x naught, f of x minus f of x naught less than epsilon, for x minus x naught less than delta. It is assumed here that x takes that on values at which the function f of x is defined. For the functional, v of y of x is the continuous at y equal to y naught of x. A function f of x is said to be continuous at x equal to x naught. For the functional, the functional v of y of x is said to be continuous at y equal to y naught of x, that is taken function. In the sense, kth order proximity, if any positive epsilon, there is a delta greater than 0 such that v of y of x minus v of y naught of x less than epsilon for y of x minus y naught of x is less than delta. So here only one point is given. Only one point is given, but the function contains lot of points. So you can write that y naught of x less than delta, y dash of x minus y dash, y naught dash of x less than delta, yk of x minus y naught k of x less than delta. So it is assumed that here the function y of x is taken from a class of functions on which the function v of y of x is defined. That is one more point. Third, a point. Next one is, some note is there. This is an important point. I believe I studied in BSc level maybe. This point. This is only used, but the question will not come based on this. We will use only that definition. The space M is called metric. Already we have studied about the metric space, na? Metric space. Where you have studied the metric space? Where you have studied the metric space?
Real analysis.
In the real analysis, in the real analysis, in the BSc level or MSc level? MSc level, did you study the real analysis?
Yes, sir.
Last semester is there, first semester or second semester?
First semester.
First semester, okay. What is called metric space? What are the properties of the metric space? How many properties are there of the metric space? A space M is called the metric if your function rho of y comma z. What is meant by rho of y comma z? Anybody? What is meant by rho of y comma z? Is it the distance or the neighborhood? What about y and z? Everything is there in the slide now. The space M is called a metric if the function rho. Usually what is called rho? What is called rho here? Rho is radius or radius of curve or distance between two points or distance between two spaces.
So I think this distance
between. Distance is okay.
For two points.
If the function rho of y comma z is defined in it, of a pair of points, is there na? Pair of points of the space satisfying the following conditions for any points of the space y and z. First point is rho of y comma z is greater than or equal to 0. Note that if there is no distance, that means the distance between two points, if both the points are coincide, that means rho of y comma y, both are same, two points are same, there is no distance, that is equal to 0. always rho of y comma z greater than equal to 0, that is positive, that is very small. And to form rho of y comma z equal to 0, it follows that y equal to z, it is same thing na. So second one is rho of y comma z equal to rho of z comma y, reflexivity. See, in the set theory also some rules are there. The reflexivity, three rules are there. I'm not able to remember all the rules. If you remember that rules, easily you can remember this. Rho of y comma z equal to rho of z comma y. Third one, rho of y comma z less than or equal to, I'm asking very simple question. Parents and son are reflexivity or not? If two sets are there, the two sets, parents, their children's, is it reflexivity? Don't know. See, what is mean by reflexivity? If very simple, parents, and if you are relating two things, if you are taking that reciprocal also, it should be same. Don't know that. Okay, so please go through this basics, it's much more important. Rho of y comma z, rho of z comma y. Otherwise, you can go through that. What is the within this end of the class? At least tell me what is the exact meaning of this reflexivity in set theory. Rho of y comma z less than or equal to rho of y comma u, in between some points are there, intermediate point. Then you can write it is like integration, definite integral. Rho of y comma discontinuous. The one integral can be written as a finite number of subintervals. It is like that rho of y comma u plus rho of u comma z. It is known as triangle law. The function rho is called the distance in M space. So here given rho is called the distance in M space. The metric space M is complete when that metric space is to be complete. If every fundamental sequence of points of the space M converges in that space. Recall that a sequence y1, y2, yn is called fundamental if for every epsilon greater than 0, there is a number n of epsilon such that for n greater than or equal to n of epsilon, the distance rho of yn plus m less than epsilon for any interval m greater than 0. So, this is one important definition. The metric space. Next one is the continuation of the last one. Consider a complete metric space C whose points are all possible continuous function y of x defined on the interval x naught minus h naught less than or equal to x less than or equal to x naught plus h naught. There are two interval points are there when that is this is said to be continuous function y of x. Okay, when h naught tends to 0, when limit you take that h naught tends to 0, then x naught equal to x equal to sorry f of x naught equal to f of x naught, it will become same. But when you are getting both are equal, sorry, not able to write that, f of x naught minus h, I'm writing here f of x naught minus h naught equal to f of f of x naught plus h naught. When that both are is equal, then that y of x is said to be continuous. Then that y of x is said to be continuous. Okay, this is a general definition. Whose graphs lie in the region D under distance is defined by the equation rho of y comma z. It is one definition. So it is also one more MCQ. Where the maximum is taken for x varying in the interval x naught minus h naught less than or equal to x less than or equal to x naught plus h naught. So here continuation of the concept of variation. One might also define the notion of distance rho of y1 y2 between the curves y equal to y1 of x and y equal to y2 of x, and then close lying curves would be the curves with the small separation. If we assume that rho of y1 y2, see, only metric space concept using here the last page I written rho of y comma z equal to maximum of y minus z, using this concept in the variation of function, that is available in page number 54-55 in the particular book. From there I am refer and write this definition for that metric space. Once you know the definition for metric space, you can understand this concept. If we assume that rho of y1 y2 equal to maximum of y1 of x minus y2 of x, that it is, if we introduce the space metric C0, space metric or metric space C0, we have the concept of zeroth order proximity. Zeroth order proximity, if it is taken that rho of y1 y2, it is one important formula. This is one important formula. Rho of y1 y2 equal to summation of that p equal to 1 to k y1 p of x minus y2 p of x. It may be the dash y1, if it is a zero that is zero, y1 0 minus y2 0. 0 means that mean y1 of x minus y2 of x. Otherwise y1 dash of x minus y2 dash of x. It is based on proximity only. It is assumed that y1 y2 have continuous derivatives up to that order k inclusive. Then the proximity of the curves is understood in the sense of kth order proximity. So here one more point already we have written. It is a kth order proximity. From the definitions, it follows that if the curves are close in the sense of kth order proximity, then they are definitely close in the sense of that any lesser order proximity. So in general, if you are defining for the kth order proximity, no need to define for the zeroth order proximity, first order proximity, second order proximity. Okay. And then one more video tutorial yesterday I have sent that. In the video tutorial, something has given for the functional. Lagrange, Euler-Lagrange theorem. Euler-Lagrange theorem I have explained clearly in the video lecture. So once I, because this concept is somewhat difficult, if I am not able to explain in that sense of, see, I am not able to figure it out, then I am not able to draw any diagrams. Mean immediately I will send some video lectures. Please you see that the video lectures, they have clearly explained that in the figure or diagrams or some animation. If you see the animation, usually you can understand that the concept. Fourth, already we have discussed three points. The fourth point is, what are the properties of the function and functional? But function questions will not come, only functional questions will come. So you have to concentrate in functional. Only we are using that function, since the concept of the, easily we can understand the concept of the function properties. So based on this, easily we can understand the functional properties also. That's why we are comparing functional and functionals. There is no other reason. A linear function is the functional L of x that satisfies the following conditions. What are the conditions are there? One is L of c of x equal to c L of x. That means we can take that c outside constant. Second one is linearity property. What is the linearity property? L of x1 plus x2 equal to L of x1 plus L of x2. That is called the linearity property. Third one is L of x equal to some kx. L of x equal to kx. That means that L of x is the function of x, but it is a multiple with some scalar value k. Multiple with some scalar value k. Similarly, for the function also, we can define that a linear functional is a functional L of y of x that satisfies the following conditions. L of c of y of x equal to c L of y of x, where c is the arbitrary constant, and L of y1 of x plus y2 of x equal to L of y1 of x plus L of y2 of x. That the first one is this, we are taking that constant outside. Second one is it is the linearity property. The third one is L of y of x is what? L of y of x is what? X0 to x1 p of x into y plus q of x into y dash dx. P of x into y plus q of x into y dash dx. Already we have written one more value, y of x. Sometimes we are taking that y of x plus epsilon into eta of x. For the Euler theorem, we have taken this function. It is similar, like that is in includes that x. This function includes that x, y, y dash. Includes the function x, y, y dash. Okay. Next one is fifth point. Fifth point is if the increment of the function delta f equal to f of x plus delta x minus f of x may be the represented in the form delta f equal to a of x delta x plus beta of x comma delta x into delta x. Okay. You know that it is the denominator of the differential formula. What is the differential formula? You know the delta f by delta x means limit delta x tends to 0 f of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x. Is a differentiation formula actually. Is a differential operator. Delta is a differential operator. Is it not? So, if the increment of the function delta f may be represented in the form where a of x does not depend on delta x. A of x does not depend on delta x and beta of x comma x tends to 0 as delta x tends to 0. Then the function is called the differentiable. When the function is called the differentiable, while the part of the increment is the linear with respect to delta x minus a of delta x is called the differentiable of the function and it is denoted by df. That's why I am telling that dividing by the delta x. Dividing by the delta x and passing to the limit delta x tends to 0, that is called the derivative. That is, then the function is said to be the differentiable. Dividing by delta x, that's why I'm told here you have to divide by delta x and then taking that limit delta x tends to 0. Here you have to take that delta x tends to 0, then it is, you can write this as delta f by delta x. So this only you can write as df by dx. Every time no need to write that delta f by delta x. So approximately we can write that df by dx. We find that a of x f dash of x and hence df is f dash of x into delta x. So if the increment of the function, so for the functional we can see that if the increment of the functional delta v of y of x plus delta y minus v of y of x may be represented in the form delta v, whatever here they have written, the same thing they are written here. Delta v can be written as L of y of x comma delta y plus beta of y of x comma delta y maximum of delta y. Instead of writing delta x, here we have to write that maximum of mod delta y, where L of y of x delta y is a functional linear with respect to delta y, and maximum of delta y is the maximum value of mod delta y, and beta of y of x delta y tends to 0 as maximum of delta y tends to 0. Then the part of the increment of the functional, the linear with respect to delta y. So when that is said to be, so here variation, one more time the variation word is common. When that L of y of x delta y is said to be variational, the part, so from here you have to study that. Here the word differentiable is come, here the word variation is come. So instead of writing differential in ordinary, then in the variation of calculus of variation, they have written as variation. So what are the equal words for the ordinary differential and variation of calculus, sorry, calculus of variation? Here we have written that as a differential, here we have written that variation. Thus, what is the next point? Thus, the variation of the functional is principal part of the increment of the function, which part is linear in delta y. In the examination of functional, the variation plays the same role as the differential does. So that's why I'm telling. So what are the words are equal? Variation plays the same role as the differential does in the investigation of function. Okay. In the case of, in the examination of functionals, the variation plays the role. In the differential, plays the role the function. Another, almost equivalent definition of the differential of the function and the variation of the functional may be given. Consider the value of the function f of x plus alpha of delta f, delta x for the fixed x and delta x, varying values of the parameter alpha. For alpha equal to 1, what happened? F of x plus delta x. So f of x plus delta x is the increment value. F of x plus delta x is the increment value. That is, we get an increased value of the function f of x plus delta x. For alpha equal to 0, what happened? Alpha equal to 0 means the function, same function f of x, we will get the same function f of x. We will get, so here given that for alpha equal to 0, we get the initial value of the function f of x. It may be readily verified that the derivative of x plus alpha of delta x with respect to that alpha for alpha equal to 0 is equal to the differential function f of x at the point x. Indeed, by the rule of differentiating a composite function, what is meant by composite function? Composite function. When that function is said to be composite, f composite g. What is mean by f composite g? What is mean by composite function? No one. Function of function, composite function means what? G of f of x is it composite?
Is it composite function?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Dou by dou alpha, f of x plus delta x when alpha tends to 0, then we can write that this can be written as f dash of x plus alpha delta x where alpha tends to 0. So we will get that f dash of x into delta x, that is d of f of x. Next one is, in the same way, for the functions of several variables, we are defining that. So one can obtain the differential by differentiating f of x1 plus alpha delta x1, x2 plus alpha x2, xn plus alpha delta xn with respect to the alpha, assuming alpha equal to 0. Indeed, it is for the functional. The previous page, it is for the function. It is defined for the function. Here it is defined for the functional. Okay, these are the few concepts now. So yesterday, up to this only I have said. Any other concept I have said? Fourth point, fifth point. Oh, lot of points are there. Some more points are there in this. Some other points are there. Yesterday I was sent up to this point, I think. Limit alpha tends to 0, beta of y of x, comma alpha delta y, maximum delta y equal to 0. Up to this you have to study your own. Okay, so from the starting, from the here, from here, from here, variation and its properties, how many properties we have discussed, 2, 3, zero third approximity, first third approximity, k third approximity, and then third a point, that means fourth point, and then it is calculus metric space, metric space definition. Otherwise, I will share that slide afterwards to copy this metric space definition. As in the yesterday notes, I didn't give the metric space definition. The point we have discussed up to the first study. And then sixth point is, the latter definition of a variation is somewhat broader than the former. So up to last page, we have discussed a few basic things. So hereafter we will discuss some more advanced concepts. The latter definition of the variation is somewhat broader than the former, since there are instances of the functionals from the increment of which it is impossible to isolate the principal linear part, but the variation exists of meaning of the second definition. What are the definitions are there? Sixth point, the differential of the function f of x is equal to, you can write this point. From hereafter you have to write, as up to yesterday you have written, sorry, I have given up to that fifth point. Yeah, up to fifth point I have given. Sixth point you can note down that the differential of the function f of x is equal to dou by dou alpha f of x comma alpha delta x at x alpha equal to 0. The variation of the functional v of y of x is equal to that dou by dou alpha v of y of x plus alpha delta y at alpha equal to 0. So you have to copy that. Previous two classes I have given the notes. Yesterday I have sent one notes. Today also we will discuss something. You have to copy the notes
The next class I will check all the notes. In the next class I will check the notes. You have to write without fail. You put the separate notebook for this subject, calculus of variation and classical mechanics. Next definition, did you write it? This one? Anybody didn't write? Are you writing or not?
Yes, sir.
Ajita is there? Ajita? Is this number 12 here? Is this number 12?
Sir?
20. First class absent, ma'am. First two class absent.
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Sir, vaccine poda poitan, sir.
Vaccine poda
poitan. Aprom, is this number 9? First class absent, ha? Illa. 26, sir. Swedita. Swedita? Swedita absent or present? Or no?
Chat box.
Chat box. First render class absent. Huh? Yeah, you have cardio work?
Mic problem is message, chat problem.
அதெல்லாம் புரியாது. அது அவங்க சரி பண்ணிக்கணும். நெக்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸ்
வரும்போது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் மட்டும் தான் ஆப்சென்ட் சாட் பண்ணிருக்காங்க சார்.
ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அதான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் 2 ஹவர்ஸ். ஓகே எனிவே ப்ளீஸ் காப்பி தி நோட்ஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் 2 ஹவர் நோட்ஸ். ஃபைன். சோ நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் மேக்ஸிமம் அண்ட் ஸ்ட்ரிக்ட் மேக்ஸிமம். நெக்ஸ்ட் டெஃபினிஷன். Maximum under strict maximum. A functional v of y of x reaches a maximum on a curve. A functional v of y of x reaches a maximum on a curve. Y equal to y of x. I will read that. No need to see that that screen again and again. So for every word, no need to see that screen. I will read, then you have to write out. Write that maximum under strict maximum. A functional v of y of x, a functional v of y of x reaches a maximum on a curve. On a curve, y equal to y dash of y equal to y naught of x, not y dash. Y naught of x. If the values of the functional, if the values of the functional v of y of x. The values of the functional v of y of x on any curve close to y equal to y naught of x close to y equal to y naught of x do not exceed v of y naught of x. Do not exceed v of y naught of x. That is delta v equal to v of y of x minus v of y dash of x v of y naught of x not y dash. Y naught of x, v of y naught of x is less than or equal to 0. Of course, if the increment is how that it is possible to less than or equal to 0. Delta v is the increment function. How that increment function is less than 0, negative? When it is possible, So if delta v less than or equal to 0 and delta v equal to 0, both case delta v equal to 0 only for y naught of x equal to y of x, y naught of x equal to y of x, that means there is no difference, there is no distance, then it is said that a strict maximum, then it is said that a strict maximum is reached on the curve, a strict maximum is reached on the curve y equal to y naught of x. Curve y equal to y naught of x. The curve y equal to y naught of x, curve y equal to y naught of x, on which a maximum is achieved. On which a maximum is achieved is defined in similar fashion. Is defined in similar fashion. In this case, delta v greater than or equal to 0. In this case, delta v greater than equal to 0. For all the curves close to the curve. Y equal to y naught of x. Y equal to y naught of x. Okay, this is the one important definition. This is one important definition: maximum and strict maximum. Next one. It is also the MCQ. Actually, proof is there. Proof no need for this. For this theorem, proof is there. Proof no need. The state and proof will not come. Only the statement is important. Theorem: if a differentiable function f of x achieves a maximum or a minimum at an interior point x equal to x naught, in the first class itself, I told na. When it is said to be that when it is reaches the maximum or minimum, when the first order df equal to 0, when you solving the df equal to 0, you get some points. That points are called anybody? Once a function f of x is there, if you are finding that the first order derivative dy by dx, that means f dash of x. Or df equal to 0, when you are solving, see, df equal to 0, you get some points, some roots. That roots are called
stationary points.
Stationary points, very good. So one that is one point, stationary points means if x equal to 1, x equal to 2, x equal to 3, like that, yeah, that is for the ordinary differential. For the partial differentiation, two points will come, pair of points will come. Okay, df equal to 0. So the same time, how to define for that maximum and minimum? If the functional v of y of x having a variation achieves maximum or minimum at y equal to y naught of x, if a functional v of y of x having a variation achieves a maximum or minimum at y equal to y naught of x, where y of x is an interior point of the domain, where y of x is an interior point of the domain. What does mean by interior point of the domain? When you are finding the distance, and then if you substitute the points, when you are substituting the points in the function, and then when you are finding the distance, that should be inside the contour. Are inside the circle, are inside the domain, an interior point of the domain of definition of the functional, then at y equal to y naught of x, delta v equal to 0. I want to ask one question: what is mean by contour? Did you study complex analysis? See, again and again, only that Jacques Boulang-Alinger has replied me.
Others are simply sitting and watching. What is this? Please try. What is meant by contour? One important integration is there, contour integration. Did you heard this? Contour integration.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then what is mean by contour?
Sir, this.
It is a continuous chain of a finite number of regular arcs.
Correct only. What is mean by residue? Residue. Saurav Kumar Katiyar has taken na residue poles singularity. Last semester only you have studied. You have studied that na, how to find that residue, Gauss residue theorem.
Yes.
Gauss integral formula. Okay, fine. Anyway, all the subjects are interrelated one. Next one is, this is the seventh point. Next one is note on extrema. It's very lengthy. Okay, tomorrow we will see that note on extrema. The next class we will discuss this. So please note, in the next class compulsory I will check the notes. Please copy the all the notes. That's it. Your attendance 1.
Yes, sir.
2.
Present, sir.
3.
Present, sir.
4. 5.
Present, sir. Present,
6,
sir.
7.
Present,
7,
sir.
Yeah.
7 present, sir.
8.
Present, sir.
9.
Yes, sir.
10.
10%, sir.
11.
Present, sir.
12.
Present, sir.
13.
Yes, sir.
Emma, 12. This is number 12.
Present, sir.
Present. சும்மாவே பேசினது முன்னால், அதாவது போறதுக்கு முன்னால ஒரு மெசேஜ் கூட அனுப்ப மாட்டீங்களா நீங்க? ஒரு மெசேஜ் அப்படி இந்த மாதிரி போறேன், லீவ்ல போறேன் சார், எதுவும் இன்ஃபார்ம்லாம் எதுவும் பண்ண மாட்டீங்களா நீங்க? இனிமேல் லீவ் போறதுன்னா முன்னால இன்ஃபார்ம் பண்ணுங்க.
ஓகே சார்.
இல்லைன்னா 1 week ஆப்ஷன் போட்டு. இது இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் கிடையாது. நீங்க போஸ்ட் இது வந்துட்டீங்க, போஸ்ட் கிராஜுவேட் படிக்கிறீங்க, இம்ப்ரூவ் பண்ணிக்கணும். அதே மாதிரி இனிமேல் ஒன்லி அட்டெண்டன்ஸுக்கு மட்டும்தான் நீங்க பைக் ஆன் பண்ணுவீங்கன்னா அட்டெண்டன்ஸே கொடுக்க மாட்டோம். கோ த்ரூ பண்ணிட்டு வாங்க, சப்ஜெக்ட் கொஞ்சம் வாங்க. 13.
எஸ் சார்.
14.
பிரசன்ட் சார்.
15.
பிரசன்ட் சார்.
16.
பிரசன்ட் சார்.
17.
Present, sir.
18.
Present, sir.
19.
Present, sir.
20.
Present, sir.
21.
Present, sir.
22 Nandini Devi present. 23
present sir.
24
yes sir.
25
present sir.
26 illa.
27
chat box sir. 27
present sir.
28 illa. 29
7 present.
போட்டிருக்காங்க அதையும் பாருங்க. இங்க வந்து நோட்ஸ் கொடுக்க மாட்டாங்க, ஆனா எக்ஸ்பிளைன் பண்ணுவாங்க. நோட்ஸ் எதுவும் அவைலபிள் இருக்காதுல, எக்ஸ்பிளைன் பண்ணுவாங்க. அதையும் நீங்க பாத்துட்டீங்கன்னா உங்களுக்கு யூஸ்ஃபுல்லா இருக்கும். If anybody is not paying their fees or examination, please directly go to the campus and pay there. Okay, next class now it is 10:40. Next class at 11:30. Okay, today counseling hour is there. Okay, you can take rest on today, but next class I will conduct the I will continue the class in the next week. Who is the next one? Is it free or any other?
Counseling
next hour. Counseling da na
project.
Oh, project hour. Okay, fine. Okay, please you can regularly contact your guide, then get the attendance, because already I entered the attendance through your guide only. Okay, that is, if you, your guide is not entered the attendance, you are the responsible. It is your attendance only. If you lose the attendance, then you will get the very low attendance percentage in the project hour. You are not able to submit your viva. Okay, thank you.
Thank you sir.
Thank you sir.